Welcome to the third and final episode of the exciting Parlotones Scarves on Stage Tour. This is Bands on the Run.
Bus smells like balls.
And right now the band is running from the smell that is intoxicating our bus. But as a team, we overcome the garbage and spend the morning laughing and frolicking on one of Hutch's boats.
Yeah, we just about to leave from Port Alfred and go to Knysna, the last leg of our journey. This is the fifth day.
We gotta go, guys.
Okay, thanks for sitting in the cold weather. You've given me quite a nice view of your nipples.
Great, thanks.
One thing that impresses me about the Parlotones is the amount of energy they have, especially at this point of the journey. So I decide to throw them off a bridge.
This is hectic. I'd rather start with the lowest bungee in the world and not the highest one, to be dead honest.
Unfortunately, we find only three of us are real men. Neil, Paul, and Jonathan, the cameraman, back out. They're little girls.
Lucky number 49.
Yeah, right.
And now, this is the time when we find what it takes to be a real man.
What I will say is when you get out there and you stand on the edge, just turn your brain off. Don't think. All right. As soon as you start thinking, that's when you're going to get scared. Okay, so brain off, jump. When you get back up, turn it back on again.
This all sounds very simple. However, the closer we get to the edge, the thinner the bungee cord looks. Every step is harder to take, and smiles are becoming harder to fake. Suddenly, I want to join the girls. Inside, I am scared, but I just cannot lie.
Why am I doing this? Why am I doing this?
Are you thinking all about our gig tonight?
I'm thinking after doing this, gigs are easy.
Unbelievable, bro. If you,
how cool is it, eh?
You feel as good as I did on that one, bro. I've almost lost my tonsils, bro.
I heard you screaming.
My man, how are you feeling now, bro?
I'm fine now.
Yeah.
Fine now.
Now you can take on the rest of the world. Okay, we're in a bit of a mad rush now. We arrived here pretty late because of our bungee jumping experience.
But we've got just enough time to plan the set with a little known Einstein method of setting the mood for music lovers.
What do you guys like about Parlotones?
We just heard them and like, okay, we have to go in front right
the
now.
The guy's voice.
Yes.
The guy's voice. Yes. That's all.
We hit the party hard but have to keep it decent because tonight we have the hectic drive back to Joburg.
Can you dispel the myth that all drummers are stupid?
What does dispel mean?
I'm fine. It's a bit hot in this bus. I'm looking forward to getting home for a while. Nice bath, sleep, and head off again.
And I think it's important to, even if there's 5 people or 1,000 people in the audience, to always have that passion, because if you don't have it, you know, the crowd aren't going to respond with that same sort of passion.
Like Connor was saying, that's our dream, it's our ambition, to carry on forever, make a living off music.
I think one of the nicest things is pulling into like Grahamstown or Cape Town or Durban, somewhere out of your little local area, and people come into your shows out of their own free will, you know? People come in there and they know your songs and they know you and they've bought your album and into your website, and it's actually just, it makes you realise that all this work that we're doing is actually making slow impact, you know, so.
This is the end of the road for me, but the Parlotones are going to continue to play and keep the soul of South African rock alive for us to all enjoy. I wish everyone could experience the freedom of being able to express yourself in this way, but hey, that's why we have rock stars, to live the life and tell us a story through the only way they know how, rock and roll.